Hi, my name's Rob. I'm a graduate engineer and I work at Nestlé. Here in Fordham, up in Newcastle, we work on chocolate and confectionery products. So we actually make quite a huge range of products. I think there's 179 different actual packaged products that come out of the door, ranging from fruit pastels and all the sugar confectionery and tutti frutti, across to Drifter and Blue Ribbons, all the chocolate biscuits that we sort of make here. A manufacturing and mechanical engineer focuses on getting all the processes sorted and developed, but also then making sure that they're as efficient as they can possibly be. So we design some machines to be as compact as possible, to be as easy to use, not waste any energy, not waste any time at all. And that's one of our sort of key focuses in manufacturing. One of the large projects I've been working on at the moment has been with Drifter Caramel. So I did a lot of calculations and all the chemistry to show that our current process literally wasn't capable of producing as much caramel as we wanted to make our Drifter chocolate bars. So as a part of that, I had to completely redesign the system so we could effectively double the caramel capacity, which meant learning all about steam usage, the cookers that we use, the chemistry behind the process, designing all the electronics so it all fitted in and could all be well controlled. I have to say, working with chocolate is quite fun and really interesting. It does feel kind of like a Charlie and the Chocolate Factory sort of dream come true at times, but there are lots of differences between the sort of movies and actual reality. We don't have Oompa Loompas running around dancing in rivers of chocolate making things. We have lots of machinery keeping all the chocolate at just the right temperature to make sure it comes out with the perfect taste. Just a few degrees different can really affect chocolate's outcome, both in how it looks, how it tastes. So we need to keep that perfect all the time. So there's actually a huge focus on quality of chocolate rather than some sort of magic of making sugar such toadstools and chocolate rivers. I think I was first interested in engineering when I was actually doing my A-levels. So I was doing physics, chemistry and maths for my A-level year, and I was really interested in all of them. I didn't know which one I wanted to do at university. So I decided to go right down the middle and do engineering, where you can basically do bits of all of them and find out which bits you're most interested in. Literally, it would be impossible to do my job without knowing quite a bit of science and maths. Just in the average chocolate line, you need to know the chemistry of the chocolate, you need to know all the physics of the machinery to get that moving, the biology effects, to make sure that there's obviously no contamination of the product, so that no one gets in any harm, and making sure everything's well controlled, knowing about the touch and the taste. There's just a huge amount of science every step, and then maths comes and backs all of that up to make sure it's all being done in a well-controlled and scientific manner.